You'll never see movies like this again.
No, unfortunately.
It's the sort of humanity of the film. This is such a good nature film.
Well, the writing is so important. To anything, to a play, to a musical, to a film. The writing, unless it's on the page, you have nowhere to go. Even if you have a great leading man and a great creative woman and a great director, they have to have something on the page.
It's always bright.
Yes.
Something to play.
Absolutely.
Did you see the movies you were in?
No, I didn't want to.
You didn't want to.
And from what I understand, it did well in 3D. I made it as a 3D film, as a matter of fact. But I get letters from all of the people about this film, that this is their favorite, and even though they've seen the other one, this one stands up head and shoulders to the other.
Infinitely
better. No, because of the relationships. And, you know, it's not digital, but I don't think it needs to be.
It doesn't need to be, but it develops the characters. It's about 40 minutes before we get about the journey, and in the new film, it's about 3 seconds, and we're already on the journey. They don't take time to develop characters, and the dialogue doesn't matter. It's all special effects.
Well,
your special effects come out of characterization.
You just said what's wrong with me just today. We have writers who develop characters, even though it took a little longer to get them on. You know where they were coming from, and you were on the road with them.
But the film at that time assumed that the audience had the patience to stay. Now we're just being infected in because there's an attention deficit syndrome. There's something
yes.
Things have changed.
Things have changed.
And here the audience sat and paid attention with great interest to the development of characters before we got to all the disaster. And there's plenty, but you build up to it. Now, I saw you in a stage production in Northern California of Black Spirit.
Oh, yes.
60s.
Yes.
And it was infinitely better than the production that's on Broadway now. And I have a feeling that your strong point is drawing room comedy.
Oh, yes, I love comedy. I love drawing room comedy. I loved the Black Spirit. It was one of the best plays that I have done.
And you had one sort of champagne quality, bubbly, effervescent, and charming, and I laughed and everything.
Now, was it
you did, with a diaphanous gown, it was delightful. Was it ever a burden to you being so darn good looking?
He's doing let's see, what is it doing at the Algonquin, the opening of the Theater?
$1,000.
It should be $1,000. He's doing a television series, so he couldn't do $1,000, but he put them in Coruscant, which opens at the Algonquin, I believe, Memorial Day. So he's going to rehearse next week, in 2 weeks anyway. So he's had a whole new career as a motion picture and cabaret and theater star.
And you've just been on tour in Florida. Tell us about that.
Well, yes, I was a nice guy. What a friend. He, 7 years ago, at Carnegie Hall, there was a salute to the MGM musicals, and we had everybody who ever sang in MGM musicals to do a song. Each one had a song. So we had clips of where we sang, and then we came up and sang the same song. And I guess he got the idea to do a tribute to Hollywood musicals from that Carnegie Hall. He was a musical director and host. And so it was his idea to put a film together, little snippets of musicals starting in the 30s and going on up to now. And the people who would sing would be on the screen, you could see them, and then they'd come out and do the song, maybe one or two songs. So Jane Russell, who was in all those wonderful musicals, one of the Marilyn Monroe plays, she came out and she sang a song from that, and then she sang Buttons and Bows that she did on the Paramount Hope. And then Jane Powell came out and sang a couple of songs that she did, one with Fred Astaire and a couple of other songs she did in her films. And then Robert Osborne was the master of ceremonies, and of course, in between each of these songs, Michael Feinstein came and played the piano and sang these wonderful, wonderful songs that we haven't heard in a long time. And you know, America should be celebrated for all of the songs by Irving Berlin and all the fabulous songs that, well, there was one like Jay Livingston wrote one that you just saw with that one. Anyway, it's a celebration of Hollywood musicals, and we played four cities in Florida. We played Performing Arts Centers that had as many seats as these, this theater, which is going to be so long. I can't wait to come back and see this all finished with the red carpet down the aisle. Anyway, I hope I will come back to see that, because I'd like to think that I had something to do with it. Anyway, so we played four cities. We played Naples, we played Vero Beach, we played Palm Beach, and Sarasota. And all the Performing Arts Center and all the seats we had were all filled.
It shows that you're still appreciated. I know in January in San Francisco, you were a huge hit at the Film Noir Festival.
Oh, yes, I did. Film Noir.
You were slightly scarlet. Do you know that? Very naughty. And the reason naughty was
because they thought. Oh, I really enjoyed that. I really think that if you do something that you enjoy, it lasts longer and are happier as a person.
In addition to acting, you've had other careers. You've been a writer, a columnist, you have your own cosmetics line, or TV hostess. You never stopped working.
That I would like a box of chocolates or going to lunch with gals. I always like to do things that help other people and for themselves.
We've done that time. Hasn't this been a treat?